Hello, my name is Angelo Paratico. I'm the author of this book, Leonardo da Vinci, a Chinese Scholar, Lost in Renaissance Italy. When this book came out, the press picked up just one part of the story, that is, that the mother of Leonardo da Vinci could have been a Chinese slave, and that the Mona Lisa could have been an image, that's what I say. Could have been an image of his mother. Therefore, Mona Lisa Chinese. That was the story. But in my book, I was making other claims, and we are discussing tonight of one of them. That is, that Leonardo da Vinci was a pedophile, and perhaps, I'm afraid, a child molester. Pedophile means a lover of boys, but also it doesn't mean sex. It means love, the form, the way they move, the boys. And this probably was a fact because we can see sketches in the Windsor collection, especially, where we see boys naked, jumping, moving. And therefore, he appreciated the male body, especially in young people. This idea is well known, but few people dare to speak it out as I am doing now, and I hope nobody will be offended about it. This is an idea that was first put forward by Sigmund Freud in his book that was published in 1911, in which he say that the fact that Leonardo da Vinci had no contact with women throughout his life was probably related to his sexual inclination. I would like to quote a part taken from the book of Freud, which is quite interesting. Sigmund Freud saw in Leonardo exaggerated love for animals because Leonardo da Vinci was vegetarian, a common trait of people who had sadistic tendency as children. Adding that, and these are the words of Sigmund Freud, a powerful wave of repression brought this childhood excess to an end and established the dispositions which were to become manifest in the years of puberty. Because his love for his mother had been repressed, this portion was driven to take up a homosexual attitude and manifested itself in an ideal love for boys. We don't know if it was ideal or not, or carnal, but in fact, we should remember that Leonardo da Vinci, when he was 24 years old, got the scare of his life. He was in prison with three other boys in Florence by being accused anonymously of sodomy. The four boys were put in jail and they were accused of having sodomized a certain boy, 17 years old, Jacopo Saltarelli. They were later acquitted. Under the condition that they will not repeat. So it was not a real acquittal. Probably they admitted that something has happened. What saved the day for them was the fact that one of the boys, or the young man, was a Tornabuoni. He belonged to the Tornabuoni family. That means the family of Florence the Magnificent, the ruler of Florence. So the case became political, so that's why he was let it go. Another point that give us a hint that Leonardo da Vinci could have had pedophilic attraction was the fact that his pupil in his workshop were beautiful boys and not very clever, not very good at painting or sketching. The first to come to mind, the first and favorite of Leonardo da Vinci was a boy called Salai. He was born in a poor family. We know from a note in the Codex Atlanticus of Leonardo that he entered Leonardo household when he was 10 years old. And this boy had a great hold of Leonardo da Vinci because he never fired him, in spite of the fact that he noted that he was pig-headed, he was a glutton, he was stealing all the time and lying. But anyway, Leonardo da Vinci could not get rid of him, probably because he liked him very much, and he kept him until his death in France in 1519. This boy, Salai, in fact became rich through this special friendship with Leonardo da Vinci. This we know because not many years ago in Milan was found some documents proving what he left to his two sisters. Because after the death of Leonardo da Vinci, Salai came back to Milan, probably with the Mona Lisa, beside precious stones, pearls, silk fabric. But then he got involved in a brawl with some French soldier and he was shot. He was still very young. So the two sisters of Salai start to fight over his possession. That's why we have a ruling from the Tribunal of Milan specifying all the riches of this man, this young man. Another pupil of Leonardo da Vinci was Melzi, Francesco Melzi. He was from a noble family, but also a very beautiful boy. And Leonardo, with him, also has a special attachment. And also Melzi remained faithfully until the end with Leonardo da Vinci. And he received as prize of his loyalty to him all the manuscript of Leonardo da Vinci. One thing that made Sigmund Freud write his book was his finding of a dream of Leonardo da Vinci while studying the flight of birds. And Leonardo da Vinci, while he described the flights of birds, stated that the earliest remembrance he had as a boy was of a bird, a kite, landing on his cradle and inserting his tail into his mouth. According to Sigmund Freud, this could be a description of sexual harassment. Somebody must have harassed Leonardo da Vinci, or could have harassed Leonardo da Vinci. And in my opinion, the culprit of this violence could have been his adopted father, because the mother of Leonardo da Vinci was made pregnant by Ser Piero da Vinci, but Ser Piero da Vinci, immediately after, the same year, married a 16 years old rich girl from Florence. So the mother of Leonardo da Vinci was given in marriage to a worker in the Da Vinci estate in the countryside. It is possible that this man could have made some violence, sexual violence, on Leonardo da Vinci. And from modern psychological studies, we know that child molesters were normally molested themselves. We don't know exactly the psychological mechanism, but this violence that a boy or a young girl is going through when she or he are small translate in great mental confusion and the sense of rage and a real push to treat other people with the same abuse. So we think Leonardo da Vinci could have been abuse, then become obsessed with the image of his mother. He never had contact with women in a sexual manner, but was attracted throughout his life to boys. This is something that a few historians of Leonardo da Vinci are ready to accept, but I am afraid this is the truth. This is the truth coming out from documents and from facts.